There we go. There we go. Good morning. Good morning, family. Happy Friday to every single one of you. Welcome to the Word and Prayer. And of course, this is The Way Evangelistic Ministries. We are so excited to be with every single one of you in the presence of your Heavenly Father. And I know that you are as excited as I am this morning to have a great man of God with us here this morning, Pastor Harry Charles Carlson the second. He's in the house. He's in the house here this morning. I had to call you by all of your names here this morning, Pastor Harry. the second. It sounds like a king's, you know, name, Harry Charles.
Yeah.
Carl said the second.
The second, yeah.
Hallelujah.
My dad was the first.
Your dad was the first.
My grandson is the third.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We're so excited to have you with us here this morning, Pastor H. What a time. I can almost feel it in my spirit. We're going to have a great, great time here this morning in the presence of the Lord. So go ahead, people of God. Tag someone. Tag your friends, your colleagues, your family members. I know that God is going to speak to his people this morning. So come on, do us a favor this morning. Tag some people. And while we are at it, I want to welcome you before I ask Pastor Harry to greet you as well this morning. I want to greet you this morning. Sandra Coleza out in Centurion. Good morning. Good morning. Together with your family, Brother Jabu Coleza and the children. Njabulo Litlotlo, thank you for joining us here this morning. We've got Lubabalo out in Bryanston this morning, watching in Johannesburg. Wow. We've got Unati from Four Ways. Wow. Praise the Lord. Fifi Sali is the wife to Lubabalo. They both in Bryanston here this morning. The Lord bless you guys. Rifilwe Mapojani out in Centurion. Good morning. Patricia. She's just here in Montana, Durinport. Thank you for joining there, Patricia. We've got Maria watching out in the United States of America. Thank you so much there, Maria, for joining us this morning. Lizzie is also watching from Montana. Good morning, good morning. Isabel Mulman, she says, morning, everyone. What a beautiful morning it is. So grateful to be alive and full of joy.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise be to the living God this morning. Maria Spetter out in Jeffreys Bay. Thank you for joining us here this morning. We've got Victor Nomvela. He says, morning, Pastor T and P. Well, brother Victor, it's Pastor T. I'm going to ask you to change that this morning. You see what happens when you're so used to having Pastor T and P every morning.
Yeah.
This morning, we've got Pastor T and Pastor H.
Yeah.
So quickly change that to morning, Pastor T and H. Brother Victor, good morning to you. Hallelujah. Lerato Mukwana is watching. Josiah Mlambo out in Soshanguve. Wow, so many people watching us here this morning. A great, great man of God, Josiah. He's a great worshiper there, wow. Pastor Harry. A great worshiper of the Lord. We've got Fetzi watching out here in Montana as well. Makebo Piladi Siabonga Ngombane. It's so good to see every single one of you. And thank you for tagging those friends and family members of yours here this morning. Pastor H, greet the people of God. Here they are. You can maybe, if you feel like it, go through some of the greetings there and just... And just speak to the people of God. Greet them as well this morning. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Good morning. Good morning.
Hallelujah.
Well, I greet you all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to each and every one of you watching this morning. I know for a fact that you came out expected. We know for a fact that your expectation is God's invitation.
Amen.
Your expectation is God's invitation. So that means that God will meet you at your most desperate time. God will meet you at your place of expectation.
Praise the Lord.
As a business leader, as a mother, as a father, an employee, an employer, doesn't matter who you are, as a pastor, as a child of God, as an ambassador for Christ, your expectation this morning is God's invitation.
Come
in
on.
Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, Pastor Harry. Amen. I hope you guys are getting ready. You are tagging some people right there this morning. And wow, Even as we're about to get into the word here this morning, at that we're starting to hear the rain falling out here in Montana. I believe it's throughout Pretoria.
Yeah.
But that speaks of the blessing of the Lord here this morning.
Hallelujah.
And we're going to open up in prayer as we usually do, people of God. Mm-hmm. The Bible says, commit your plans to the Lord and he Amen. Shall establish them.
Amen.
So therefore, we're going to do that right now. So join us in prayer as we commit this session to the Lord.
Mm.
Father, we give you the praise.
Yes.
We give you the honor. We give you the glory. You are still the Christ, the Messiah. You are seated in heaven, Father. I thank you that your word declares that you are forever mediating. You are forever interceding for your people. Therefore, Father, I pray this morning that even as you intercede for your people, that our faith will increase.
In Jesus'
you will
name.
Increase our faith. In the name of Jesus, I pray for the word that will come forth this morning, Father. Let it be like a hammer. Let it break into pieces every snare of the fowler, every agenda of the enemy concerning God's people. I pray that your word will be living and active in the lives of your people.
Hallelujah.
Let it divide between bone and marrow. Let it cut between a soul and spirit this morning. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Father, therefore, receive our praise this morning.
Hallelujah.
Receive our worship.
Yes.
Let it be like a sweet smelling aroma unto your nostrils this morning. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord this morning. I just want to bless the people of God with this psalm. I'm going to hand over to Pastor Harry. I believe he's got a word for you this morning. But I want to read, if you got your Bibles this morning, open up your Bibles in the book of Psalm 34.
Yeah.
Psalm 34, we're going to read from verse 1 up until verse 3.
Mm.
Psalm 34. And you know what evangelist is about to say right now? That the grass withers and the flowers fades, but the word of our God shall stand forever.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord this morning. So walk through the text with me this morning. The Bible says, I will bless the Lord
at all times.
At all times. Mm. His praise shall continually be in my mouth.
In my
Hallelujah.
Mouth. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord this morning. The Bible says in verse 2, my soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad.
Oh,
magnify the Lord with. Let us exalt his name together.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Can we praise Jesus together this morning?
Yes.
Can we lift up
Father,
his name? We praise your holy
praise
name, Jesus.
Name
we exalt you,
we
mighty God. We magnify you, Jesus. We say, be lifted high.
We honor you this
be
morning.
Lifted
Our
high, Jesus.
Higher
in and higher.
You.
Place up in our midst this morning, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We worship you. We worship you.
The
King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Therefore, Father, thank you today that even as you take your rightful place today, we yield unto your presence today. We subject ourselves, Father, unto your Lordship this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank
Praise you, the Lord. Praise the Lord. Pastor H, take it away this morning.
Hallelujah.
Take it away this morning. We are hungry. We are hungry.
Well, I greet you all in Jesus' name. Every one of you that just tuned in right now, it is so great to be there in your living room, there in your house,
Hallelujah.
There in your dining
Come
room.
On.
There in you, I know for a fact some of you might be sitting in bed and have your phone right there or your tablet right there. Right there.
Hallelujah.
It's so great to your house, and I want to say this, that God is with you. God is not against you,
Hallelujah.
And God will touch you. As I said earlier, your expectation is God's invitation.
Thank you.
Doesn't
Jesus.
Matter where you find yourself. I want to get into the word. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 37. Let's open our Bible. The 37. The Bible says, Jacob, the liar, the trickster, the cheat. Jacob, the liar, the trickster, the cheat.
Hey.
The liar, trickster, the cheat.
My
Jacob. Jacob lived in the land where his father had sojourned in the land of Canaan. These are the generations of Jacob. Jacob being Joseph. Joseph being 17 years old tended the flock of his father with his brothers and was an assistant to the sons of Bilhah and Zilpah. So that means it shows already that here you already have a dysfunctional family with a man with How many wives?
Sure.
So it shows you he was an assistant to the sons of Bilhah and Zilpah, his father's wives, and Joseph brought a bad report about them. It shows already the rivalry between brothers, between siblings.
Yes.
Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children because he had been born to him in his old age, and he made him a long ornamented robe for him. His brothers saw that his father loved him more than all of his brothers, and they hated him and couldn't speak a kind word to him. Now Joseph had a dream, and he told this to his brothers, and they hated him all the more. And he said, please listen to my dream, and look, we were binding sheaves in the field, and look, my sheaf arose and also stood upright, and look, your sheaves gathered around it and bowed down to my sheaf. Then the brothers said to him, will you indeed reign over us, or will you indeed rule over us? So they hated him all the more. Say all the more.
All the more.
Say all the more.
All the more.
Yes, yes. I do not know who you are.
Yes.
You might be hated for the anointing upon your life, and you might be hated for your vision. You might be hated for your dream. You might be hated because you told your brothers, your sisters, that this is what God has placed in your life.
Yes.
You might be hated for the vision that you have as a pastor, and you told it to the congregation, and your siblings don't like you because of your tenacity, because of your courage, because of the fact that you are such a bold person.
Yeah.
There's no arrogance in this. It's boldness. The Bible says in Proverbs 28 verse 1 that the righteous is as bold as a lion.
Hallelujah.
So when you speak your heart, the Bible says in Habakkuk 2, he says, write the vision on the wall and make it plain so that he that reads it may run with it.
Amen.
So everyone that reads your vision will run with it. Those that submit to you will read your vision and they will run with it. And they will run with it in Jesus' precious name. So I want to really encourage you this morning in the precious name of Jesus that you get brothers. When he told his father and to his brothers, his father rebuked him and said, what is the dream that you had? Will I and your mother and your brothers indeed come and bow down to the ground in front of you? His brothers were jealous of him, but his father kept thinking about the matter. Now his brothers went to pasture their father's flock near Shechem, and Israel said to Joseph, Aren't your brothers pasturing the flock near Shechem? Come, and I will send you to them. And said to them, I am ready. So he said to him, go now, see whether it is well with your brothers.
Mm-hmm.
And a man found him, and look, he was wandering in the field. And the man asked him, what are you looking for? He said, I'm looking for my brothers. Tell me, please, where are they pasturing the flock? Then the man said, they have left here, for I have heard them. Now they saw him at a distance, and before he reached them, they plotted against him to kill him. I want to tell you that if your dream, I want to talk to you this morning about thinking big, dreaming big, planning big, and praying big prayers.
Yeah.
Thinking big, planning big, dreaming big, and praying big prayers. Joseph was thinking big.
Yeah.
Joseph was thinking big. He was dreaming big.
Amen.
The dream scared him.
Sure.
So I want to tell you, if your dream does not scare you, you're taking a walk in the park.
Oh, Jesus.
You're taking a walk. Pastor Tower Pinky,
come on now.
If your dream with regard to evangelistic, the way evangelistic ministry does not scare you, if the dream that God has placed in my heart does not scare me, I'm taking a walk in the park with regard to the growth of the church, the increase of the church, the multiplication of the church, the cells that we have to plant, leaders that we have to raise up, churches that we have to plant, etc. If your dream does not scare you, your dream will cause people to hate you. Your dream will cause people to become envious about you. Your dream will cause people to become jealous about you. And if that is not happening, listen, you're taking a walk in the park. So
my
I want to challenge you this morning. It doesn't matter who you are.
Yes.
It doesn't matter where you've been. It doesn't matter how low you sunk. It doesn't matter how far you've dwelt away from God. Yeah. It's about time that you return.
Hallelujah.
So that the dream can be ignited in your spirit.
Amen.
So that you can become that ambassador that God has called you to
Amen.
Be. That you can stand before God on behalf of the people, and stand in front of the people on behalf of God, and stand in front of God on behalf of those that are working for
Hallelujah.
You, and stand in front of them on
Hallelujah.
Behalf of God in Jesus' precious
Jesus' name.
If you believe that right there in your
Hallelujah.
House, come on, let's give the Lord
come
the
on,
biggest
praise
that
praise
we can
Jesus
in the name
morning.
Of Jesus
Hallelujah.
Christ. I
want to
challenge you this morning. I want to challenge you. Here
wow.
you speak. A dysfunctional family.
Yeah.
First of all, they talk about the father.
Mm.
The father, the liar, the cheat. I do not know what they say about your dad.
Yeah.
I do not know whose child you are.
Absolutely.
Whether your father was whether your father is an alcoholic, or your father was an alcoholic,
yeah.
or your father had 10 wives, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
But the reality is, the Bible says in Genesis 39, and the Lord was with Joseph.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The Lord was his Savior, but I'm coming from a dysfunctional family.
The Lord.
I'm coming from a father that was a liar and a cheat. I'm coming from people that hate me.
Mm.
I'm coming from people that plotted to kill me, and they schemed.
Yes.
But the Bible says that the Lord is with Joseph.
Hallelujah. Praise
so I
God.
I tell you that the Lord is with you.
Amen.
Even
Amen.
Though you come from a dysfunctional family.
Hallelujah.
Even though your father, your mother, maybe your mother gave you up for adoption when you were born and you were raised by other people. But I want to tell you this morning that the Lord is with you. The Lord
Hallelujah.
Was with Moses when we had to be given up and put in a papyrus basket and hidden for some time in the Nile River. And the Lord was with Moses
Hallelujah.
Because the Lord knew that the destiny of Moses was already placed inside of him.
Amen.
The salvation of 3 million Israelites was already
Hallelujah.
Placed inside
of
Moses.
Hallelujah.
That's why he was hidden.
Yes.
You might not have the platform now.
Mm.
You might not be recognized now.
Yes.
You might not be honored now.
Come on.
You
come
might
on.
Not be even recognized by anyone, by your family, by your siblings, by your friends,
wow.
by your neighbors, by your acquaintances,
Stop.
By your employer, by your boss, by your CEO, HOD, SDF. Oh, you might not, and you're sacrificing,
My
you're
God.
Serving, unapologetic, unashamedly. But
Hallelujah.
Let me tell you, you are hidden. You are hidden by God, because
Hallelujah.
The Bible says the Lord. So Moses was surrounded by. He was surrounded by crocodiles. He was
yes.
surrounded by piranhas.
Yes.
He was surrounded by danger. He was surrounded by snakes.
Mm.
He was surrounded by things that could have killed him.
Yes.
He was surrounded, but the reality is,
the Lord
God was
with him.
With Moses.
Hallelujah.
God was with Joseph.
Hallelujah.
When they hated, when they plotted to kill Joseph, the Lord was with Joseph.
Praise
when they,
God.
When they put him in a cistern or in a pit, the Lord was
Hallelujah.
With Joseph.
Hallelujah.
When they decided
hey.
To gonna kill Joseph, the
yeah.
Lord decided.
Amen.
He sent angels to protect
Hallelujah.
Joseph. That's
Hallelujah.
Why you need to understand.
Mm.
If you've never understood the purpose and the reality of angels,
yeah.
study the word of God.
Mm.
The Bible says he will command the angels
yes.
to encamp around
Hallelujah.
You.
Hallelujah.
It is the same God that sent an angel in Acts chapter 5 and in Acts chapter 12 into the prison.
Hallelujah.
And he came and hit
Peter
on the hip.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, said, Hi. Wake up.
Come on now.
God, you've been lying here. Wake up.
I want to get you out of here.
I want to tell you right now, you've been lying that the angel is now coming into your house and said,
Praise
wake
God.
Up. You've been backslidden for too long.
Thank
wake
you.
Up. You've been in a prison of unforgiveness and resentment for too long. Wake up.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' precious name, rise up from the dungeon. Rise up from your discouragement.
Rise up
from your depression. Rise up. From where you are in the name of Jesus Christ.
Praise God.
You've been sitting at home. You haven't been in church for so long.
Mm.
You haven't committed yourself to serve the purpose of God.
Hallelujah.
Listen, it's about time that you come back. What's
Praise
wrong with
God.
You? How long will you sit there?
Come on now.
Don't feel like Elijah and sit under the sycamore tree and say, I'm the only one
left.
Come back in the name of Jesus Christ. Come back in Jesus' name. It's
come
your
on
time
now.
To come back. How long have you been sitting there? The Bible says, do not say there are still
Richard,
4 months left. There's still a month left.
No.
They said, I'm waiting for COVID to go over.
No.
Listen, COVID is now on vacation. The president has put COVID on leave.
Come on now.
For the elections.
He's on vacation.
Yeah. The
COVID is on
COVID
vacation.
COVID has taken a sabbatical. It's taken a sabbatical. COVID, yeah. COVID has taken us a better. Can I challenge you this morning in the name of Jesus Christ
come on now.
That you come to that place where you realize I'm showing you now, and I'm showing you a picture of a dysfunctional family. Joseph, born into a dysfunctional family. Joseph, when you study the word of God, that you see Joseph's brothers, Reuben. Reuben was the one that was born unto Leah first. And then Judah was the one that was born unto Leah last.
Come on.
But these two guys, both committed infidelity. Both of them. The one slept with the with one of his father's wives, and the other one slept with his sister-in-law. Dysfunctional family.
Dysfunctional.
And here you are. You have an excuse why you cannot operate, why you cannot become the leader that you're supposed to be. But Joseph never looked at that. Joseph never made that as an excuse. Joseph never used it as an excuse and said, oh, my brother is an infidel. My father is a liar, cheat. And they hated me. And they threw me in a pit. And they sold me to the Israelites. And they did this. Joseph got rid of every excuse.
Amen.
You know what Joseph did?
Come on.
Joseph vaccinated himself.
Ah, praise God. Come on now.
Joseph vaccinated himself with the word of God. Joseph vaccinated. Joseph was vaccinated by the presence of God. And Joseph got rid of every excuse why he could not prosper, why he could not become the governor, why he could not become. I want to tell every political leader, you sitting there, and right now you're worried about, are they going to vote? Listen, when you put your trust in the Lord,
amen.
The Bible says in Jeremiah 17,
come
verse 7, it says, blessed is the man that trusts in the Lord.
Amen.
Blessed is the woman that trusts in the Lord. Blessed is the CEO that trusts in the Lord.
Amen.
Blessed is the HOD. Blessed is the pastor.
Yeah.
Blessed is the divorced woman.
Hallelujah.
Blessed is the divorcee. Blessed is the widow. The widower. Blessed is the person that doesn't have parents. Blessed are you that trust
in the Lord. In the Lord.
And hope the Lord is.
Hallelujah.
That man shall be, that woman shall be like a tree that is planted by the rivers of water.
Thank you, Jesus.
That standeth roots out by the stream.
Thank you, Jesus.
And does not wither when heat comes.
Hallelujah.
But you forever bear fruit.
Amen.
So I want to challenge you this morning in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that you understand that Joseph came from a dysfunctional family. Joseph came from a family where the where the siblings hated him. It could have given Joseph any excuse.
Absolutely.
Why he could not. Why he could not.
Wow.
In the pit, he could have committed suicide.
It's true.
When he was sold, he could have run away.
Yeah.
But God was with Joseph.
Hallelujah.
I'm gonna tell you right now.
Praise God.
I was one of the best swimmers in Bloemfontein in the apartheid era.
Sure.
And I could have used all that.
Yeah.
I've got my dad was an alcoholic.
Yeah.
I could have used that as an excuse.
Yeah. Yeah.
I grew up in the Shebeen.
Yeah.
I could have used that as an excuse.
My God. My God.
I could have used that as an excuse, but let me tell you, when you get vaccinated by the word of God,
thank you,
when you get vaccinated by the word of God,
thank you, Jesus.
The word of God nullifies every excuse.
Absolutely.
The word of God nullifies every stronghold.
Amen.
The word of God nullifies
Amen.
Every image and imagination that is contrary to the word of God. The word of God, the Bible says in Hebrews 4:12, it says the word of God is powerful.
Yes.
The word of God is active.
Amen.
The word of God is alive.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says the word of God cuts through your bone, joint, and marrow.
Come on.
The
Come
Bible
on.
Says Hallelujah. In Jeremiah,
Hallelujah.
He says
Hallelujah.
The word of God is like a crushing hammer.
It's a hammer.
The Bible says, Hallelujah. So shall the word be.
Yes.
The Bible says that.
Amen.
The Bible says, in the beginning was the word,
Hallelujah.
And the word was with God.
Come on now.
So that means the word is God.
Hallelujah.
So every time when you pray the word, you're sending God on an air. You're sending God on an errand on behalf of you. You're sending God in your current situation.
Hallelujah.
You're sending God in your health. You're sending God because God is the word.
Hallelujah.
God is the word.
He is the word.
Some people think your Bible.
Yeah.
Your Bible is a fairy tale. This is not a fairy tale.
No.
You read this thing. The Bible says the word brings health to your flesh.
Hallelujah. Medicine.
It heals your bones.
Hallelujah.
It is medicine
to our bones.
The word.
Because Hallelujah.
Now
Hallelujah.
If the word is health to your bones, then it means the Bible says Jesus is the chief physician.
Hallelujah.
So that means
Hallelujah.
Every time when you sin, the Bible says
Hallelujah.
In Psalm 107:20, it says he sent his word to heal you.
Come on now.
He sent his word.
Amen.
He sent
Amen.
His word.
Amen.
To heal you.
Amen.
And to save you from the grave.
Amen.
To save you from calamity.
Thank
so
you,
Joseph
Thank
only
you,
had
Jesus.
One thing.
Yeah.
Amen. He had the word.
Wow.
And the word of God was the sustenance of Joseph's spirit.
Yes.
The word of God. The Bible says all things hold together because of the word.
Sure.
It was the word of God.
Absolutely.
It was the word of God. So Joseph Sure. In the midst of the betrayal, in the midst of the hatred, in the midst of animosity, in the midst of being hated by his siblings,
family members,
in the midst of the fact that his father also questioned his dream, and his mother questioned his dream, that Joseph was fully persuaded that he that started the work in him is able, he that made the promise,
thank you, Jesus,
will fulfill that he's promise.
Faithful. He's faithful.
Joseph believed
Hallelujah.
That. And I want to challenge you this morning as a pastor.
Amen.
I want to challenge you this morning as a leader.
Yeah.
I want to challenge you this morning as a husband, as a wife. I want to tell you this morning as maybe you've gone through a divorce, a painful divorce.
Yeah.
And your husband betrayed you, your wife betrayed you, and you have to raise your children alone. I want to tell you this morning, maybe you lost a loved one because of COVID.
Sure.
And right now you're feeling all alone and you feel abandoned. But I want to tell you, the Bible says in Genesis 39 from verse 1, it says, and the Lord was with Joseph. The Lord was with Joseph. So Joseph could have used all the adversity.
Absolutely.
All the challenges.
Yes.
All the betrayal, the dysfunctionality of his family.
Yeah.
He could have used that as an excuse and say, because I come from that, I cannot build the business. Because I come from this family, I cannot. Because. Sure. Let me ask you, you business leader.
Yeah.
You in church.
Yeah.
And God is expecting you to become a kingdom financier. And you recently got a big contract and you decided to have an excuse. Yeah, but it's now my time. Listen, it's your time to also finance the kingdom of God. It's also time to get away from your unbelief and get to that place and say, Father, what I receive now is not even mine. What I receive now, this contract, this tender, this employment, this opportunity to be employed, I received it from you. So everything that I own is yours.
Yeah.
So I want to honor you because I know I'm putting myself in the rhythm of the blessing of God.
Amen.
So I want, can I just add on to what I said?
Yeah.
So Joseph thought.
Sure.
So you're talking about sexual harassment in the working place, in the corporate world?
Yeah.
The Bible says in Genesis 39:5, it says, and the Lord blessed the house of Potiphar because Joseph had an understanding, because he was a steward. He had an understanding because he was a kingdom ambassador.
Yeah.
But because of the fact that he was such a punctual man at work, he was such a diligent steward, he was such an honorable man, his boss's wife fell in love with him.
Yeah.
And then she wanted to sleep with him.
Yeah.
But the reality is, listen, Joseph kept his integrity.
Praise God.
Joseph kept his morals and his values.
Praise God. Praise
Joseph.
God.
And Joseph, even though he was falsely accused for attempted rape, he went to prison. But in prison, the Lord was with him. Joseph.
Amen.
He could have had any excuse.
Again.
Why? And he could have hung himself in prison, as many people do when they get arrested because of white-collar crime or because of... your sexual sin, etc., etc. But the reality is this morning, I want to tell you, when Joseph was in prison, he said to the people, don't forget me. Then they still forgot.
They forgot him.
But God remembered. God remembered.
Hallelujah.
God remembered
Joseph.
Amen,
Pastor H.
You can have all the excuses today.
Yeah. Praise God.
You could have, you might be young this morning and you fell pregnant prematurely.
Yeah.
And you can use that as an excuse.
Yeah.
You can use that as an excuse that stops you from becoming the best you can ever be.
Yeah.
You are dynamic. You are. Tina Turner says, you are simply the best.
That's
you
it.
Are.
Amen.
As much as
Amen.
You have been betrayed and you were, maybe you were seduced or you were sexually molested while you were a child.
Yes.
But I want to tell you, the Bible says God was with Joseph.
Amen.
And I want to say this to you.
Praise
you
God.
Are simply
the best.
The best.
Hallelujah.
Simply.
Despite those challenges, Pastor H. God is with the people this morning.
Exactly.
Whatever you've gone through today.
Yeah.
And I mean, that's what I'm getting this morning, Pastor
Absolutely.
H. This is what I'm getting now. Because we go through so much as a people of God. We are born again. But we still have scars from the past.
That's right.
But that should not stop us.
It should not.
From achieving the dream and the vision that God has given you.
Absolutely.
As a child, God has given you a dream.
Yeah.
You are a parent today. You were abused as a child, but you are a parent today.
Yeah.
And Pastor H, I really feel it now. And I've just really been eating on this as you're preaching this word.
Amen.
Many of us, we might not come out and say where we come from.
Yeah.
Many of us come from dysfunctional families,
that's
Pastor
right.
Harry.
That's right.
And you know, we are born again today. We are looking good. We are looking smart.
Yeah, yeah.
But there are things that took place in our past.
That's right.
That we got to deal with.
That's right.
Because we this is not the end. You know, where we are now, I believe God still wants to use many people, even those watching this morning,
amen,
to fulfill the dream and the purpose
that's
that
right.
God has given them.
Absolutely.
Mm.
The Bible says in 2 Corinthians 10:4, it says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Yes.
But mighty in God,
yes,
pulling down. If you had had anything that happened in your past, whether it was a sexual abuse, a verbal abuse, an emotional abuse, whether it was this type of rivalry between you and your sibling, the Bible says we have the authority to pull down these strongholds, because these things of our past can definitely hold on to us.
Absolutely.
And they become a stronghold
and
they
in
hold you. You wanna build a business, but this thing is a stronghold.
It's
you wanna build a great marriage, but this thing is a stronghold.
Mm.
You wanna build a great family.
Wow.
I wanna tell you what stops you from what is the excuse that you cannot, even though your father neglected you, but you have to spend time with that
Hallelujah.
Boy of yours.
Hallelujah.
You spend time with that girl of yours.
Absolutely.
Let her feel your embrace. Let
Amen.
Her feel your hands.
Amen.
Let her feel your arms.
Jeez.
Let her feel your loving heart. Let her feel your.
Amen.
Let her feel yours. You
Amen.
Can't have an excuse to say, yeah, my father was a
did that
man.
To me.
My father did that to me. And No, because that thing becomes a stronghold
in your life.
Strong unto you, and you holding strong unto that thing, and that thing is an image, and it becomes an imagination, and it becomes a reasoning, and it becomes an excuse.
Yeah.
And the Bible says, it says, this reasoning become contrary to the word of God. I want to ask you this morning in the name of the Lord Jesus
Hallelujah.
Christ of
Hallelujah.
Nazareth, that you get to that place. That you do not hold on to that.
Aye.
You do not hold on to that matumo or matumelo.
Matume.
You do not hold on to that unati.
Yes.
You do not hold that onto that fifi.
Yes.
You do not hold on to that matumelo. You do not hold on to that in Jesus'
Sandra.
Name. Sandra,
Lizzie.
You do not hold on to your past, but you hold on to the word of God.
Amen.
The word of God is your vaccination.
Amen.
The word
Amen.
Of God is your vaccine.
Hallelujah.
The word of God is health to your flesh.
Amen.
The word of God
Amen.
Is healing to your spirit.
Hallelujah.
The word of God permeates your heart.
Hey.
The word of God transforms your mind.
Thank
the Bible
you,
says, do not be conformed to this world,
yes.
but be transformed by the renewal of your mind so
Hallelujah.
That you can know what is the good and perfect and acceptable will of God. The Bible says in Romans 12:1, present
Jesus.
Your body again unto God as a living sacrifice. Present your body that is scarred and bruised, that was violated. Present that body to God. Pastor, present your body to God. Leader, present your body to
Hallelujah.
God. Every one of you, dear
Hallelujah.
Mother, present
Hallelujah.
Your body to God
Hallelujah.
In the name of the Lord Jesus
Hallelujah.
Christ of Nazareth. Present that cancerous body to God. Present that HIV body to God. Present that shortness of breath to
Hallelujah.
God. Present it to God as a living sacrifice.
Thank you, Jesus.
Holy and acceptable to God. Present your business to God. Present
Amen.
Your company to God.
Hallelujah.
Present the corporation that you're working for to God. Present
Hallelujah.
It to God. Do not have an excuse.
Thank you,
the
Jesus.
Word of God is your vaccination this
Thank
morning.
You, Jesus.
The word of God is your transformation.
Hallelujah.
The word of God is your healing this morning.
Thank
the
you,
word
Jesus.
Of God is the thing that will revive your
Aye.
Spirit, will
Hallelujah.
Reverberate in your heart and in
Hallelujah.
Your spirit and in your mind in the name of Jesus the Christ. I declare it.
Thank
I declare
Lord.
That your name will be removed
Thank
from
you,
the
Jesus.
Book of the failures. I declare that your name will be removed from the book
Thank
of
you,
failures.
Jesus.
I
Thank
declare
you, Jesus.
That your name will be written in
Hallelujah.
The book of the history makers.
Amen.
I declare right now
in
that you
Jesus
have favor.
Name.
There are people right now that have
Hallelujah.
To take a decision with regard to your future.
Yeah.
I declare that you have favor with that decision makers. I declare that nothing.
Thank you, Jesus.
But nothing.
Hallelujah.
And no one. And no devil in hell, no witch, no
Thank
wizard,
you,
no enchantment will come against you.
Yeah.
In the mighty name
Jesus
of
name.
Jesus the Christ, I
Jesus
declare
name.
This. I speak it.
Hallelujah. Speak hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Christ,
hallelujah.
That right now, any attempt against hallelujah. Your life will be destroyed.
Yeah.
Every witch that comes against you,
yeah.
that whatever attempt is there,
come
that
on.
Thing will be returned to the sender.
Yes.
In Jesus the name of name. Jesus Christ,
Jesus
those things
name.
That are tormenting you at night,
yeah.
that those things being returned to the sender,
you,
in the name of Jesus Christ,
hallelujah.
I declare right now that you that are barren,
yeah.
that you will never have an excuse. You will become fruitful.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus Christ,
Jesus
that
name.
Birth that died will come back to life.
Yeah.
That marriage that died will come back to life.
Amen.
That child that is rebellious will come to his senses.
Amen.
According to 2 Timothy
Thank
2
you,
verse
Jesus.
26. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ,
Hallelujah.
I declare it, that your son will come to his senses.
Thank
and he will
you, Lord.
Say, I will return to my father's house.
Yeah.
I will return to God. I will return to my Savior.
Thank you, Jesus.
He will come to their senses. Do you believe that this morning?
Hallelujah.
Come on, give
Hallelujah.
The Lord the biggest praise.
Praise
come on,
God.
Give him praise. Father,
Hallelujah.
We praise you.
Hallelujah.
We honor you. We thank
Glory
you
to Jesus.
For a great transformation.
Thank you,
in
Jesus.
In the precious name of Jesus
thank
Christ.
You, Jesus.
In conclusion, I want to say this
wow.
to you.
Wow. Hallelujah.
I want to
hallelujah,
say this
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
I want to tell you that you are precious in the sight of God.
Amen.
I want to tell you that you are the apple of God's eye.
Yes.
I want to tell you it doesn't matter who you are, what you've
Thank
done,
you,
how
Jesus.
Bad you've been, how low you've done. I want to tell you Jesus loves you.
Amen.
I want to tell you, man, it doesn't matter how many men you slept with, Jesus Aye. Loves you.
Thank
I want
you,
to tell
Jesus.
You that Jesus came to a man, to a woman, that had five men and the one that she was living with was not even hers. And Jesus gave her water to drink and
yes.
she never thirsted again for
hallelujah.
Any man.
Hallelujah.
I want to tell you that Jesus
Hallelujah.
Doesn't matter whether you are caught in adultery. The Bible
hey.
Says that Jesus is the same God yesterday,
Thank you,
today,
Jesus.
And forever.
Thank you, Jesus.
I want to tell you that he's a forgiving God.
Ah.
He's a gracious God.
Mm.
He's a loving Father. He's a Prince of Peace.
Thank
the
you,
Bible
Jesus.
Says that. I want to tell you this morning
Hallelujah.
That he loves you, man.
Thank
he
you,
loves
Jesus.
You.
Thank you, Jesus.
He loves you.
Thank you,
he
Jesus.
He doesn't keep your he
Thank
doesn't
you,
keep
Jesus.
Record of your faults.
Thank you, Jesus.
He loves
ah.
you.
Thank
he
you, Lord.
Loves you, man. You might
Thank
be down and out,
Thank
but he will
Lord.
Lift you up. The Bible says
Thank
the righteous
you,
man falls seven times,
ah,
but the
Jesus.
Lord lifts him up.
Thank
I tell you,
you
right
Lord.
Now,
Thank
it's time
you, Lord.
To rise up again. No,
Thank
no
you,
excuse.
Jesus.
The word of God is vaccinating you. The word of God is vaccinating you.
Thank
the word
you,
of God is healing you.
Thank
the
you,
word
Jesus.
Of God is restoring you.
Thank
the
you,
word
Jesus.
Of God is lifting you up. The word of God is clothing
Thank you.
You.
Jesus.
The word of God is releasing
Hallelujah.
You from the prison.
Hallelujah.
The
Hallelujah.
Word of God is restoring your sight.
Hallelujah.
The word of God is restoring your hearing.
Rababa
the word of God is restoring your health. And you will be with full health again.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus,
in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Of the hurt, I break the power of the evil. I break that power now in the name of Jesus Christ. I break the power. Every scar
Thank you,
that is
Jesus.
In your life will be removed.
Hallelujah.
I pray that God
Hallelujah.
Walks back into every year of
Thank
your life,
you, Jesus.
Every month of
Thank
your
you,
life,
Jesus.
Every week of your life,
Hallelujah.
Every day of your life,
Hallelujah.
Every hour in your life,
Thank
every
you,
minute in your life,
Hallelujah.
Every second in your life. And God removes the evidence
Thank
of your
you,
past.
Lord. Thank you, Lord.
God removes
you,
the
Lord.
Evidence of your past.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's time to get rid of all excuses.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
it's
Lord.
About time that you get vaccinated by the
Come
word
on.
Of God.
By
it's
the
about
word.
Time.
By the word.
The
by
word
the
of word. God is your vaccine this morning.
Hallelujah.
The word of God, the word of God, the
Thank
word
you, Jesus.
Of God, the
Thank
word
you,
of
Jesus.
God, the
Thank
word
you,
of
Jesus.
God, the word of God,
Kakaya,
the Bible says these words are spirit and they are life.
Thank you, Jesus.
These words are spirit
Thank you,
and
Jesus.
They are life.
Hallelujah.
The Lord will remove the evidence of your past. Yet the scars might be there, but God has got a great future
Thank
for you.
Jesus.
He
Thank
says,
you, Lord.
I know the thoughts that I have towards you.
Yes. Yes.
Thoughts of peace and not
Amen.
Of evil.
Amen.
Thoughts to give you
Hallelujah.
A hope and a future.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus
Hallelujah.
Christ. I want you right there in your room.
Thank
Lift your
Jesus.
Hand right now as I pray. Father, I declare the word of God
Thank
over my
you,
brother,
Jesus.
Over my sister. I declare the word of God over every pastor.
Yes,
I declare
Lord.
The word of God, Father. I declare, Father, those that are now disgruntled, those that are discouraged, those that are on the verge of committing suicide, I cancel that plan in
yes.
Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
I declare that the Lord says to you, Pastor, and the Lord will increase the church and he will not decrease it. The Lord will cause you. According to Ezekiel 36, 37, he says,
Thank you, Jesus.
Will send you men like a flock. The Lord says it.
Hallelujah.
The Lord says it in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
And I declare now over you,
Thank you, Lord.
You will summon a nation that you do not know
to come to you.
And a nation that does not know you will
come.
I declare that people of renown will come to your place.
Yes, Lord.
People that do the people of renown will come to the house of God. People of renown will come to your business.
Hallelujah.
People of renown will come to your business and buy your products.
Hallelujah.
I declare this in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. I declare now
that your son and your daughter come to their senses in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
according to 2 Timothy 26:27, I declare that they come to their senses.
Yes,
I declare that your days of crying, your days of mourning are over.
Yes.
I declare instead of ashes, the Lord will restore you.
Hallelujah.
With the oil of gladness.
Hallelujah.
With the oil of gladness.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The Lord will lift you up.
Hallelujah.
He makes you the head and not the tail.
Thank you, Jesus.
Called you to be above only and not beneath.
Yes, Lord.
The Lord
will open.
The Lord will make you blessed in the
field, blessed in business,
blessed in the church.
Hallelujah.
Blessed will your children be. Blessed will your family be.
Thank you, Lord.
Will your wife be. I open now that womb that
yes.
is now closed. I open it in the name
of Jesus.
I open it in Jesus' name.
I declare now
that I present your body now.
Hallelujah.
For the purpose of God.
Hallelujah.
In the precious name of Jesus
Christ. Thank you, Jesus.
I want to ask, while every head is bowed and every eye closed, no one moving.
Hallelujah.
Right there in your house, maybe at one stage you serve God, but you've wandered away, you've grown cold. It's time that you return.
Name of Jesus in the mighty by family. You have been restored today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to Jesus. Thank you, Pastor Pinky, for just helping us there behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Thank you so, so much. I believe the video has been restored. But we want to thank the man of God. Come on, let's give Pastor Harry a clap offering this morning. Hallelujah. Come on, give him a clap offering. Give him a clap offering right now. Hallelujah. You can just drop those high fives for Pastor Harry. He poured himself out this morning.
He gave all
of himself this morning. You know, he's been used by God mightily, mightily. A great man of God that we look up to in the kingdom of God. Amen. Therefore, Pastor H, I believe the Lord sent you with an assignment here this morning. A great assignment.
Hallelujah.
To deliver people.
Yeah.
I feel this was deliverance that took place in the life of people.
Amen.
Here this morning. Hallelujah. If you've received your deliverance, I see those high fives. I see all of you. May the Lord bless you. Come on, let's high five them. Let's high five them.
All.
Pastor
high
Harry,
five.
Let's high five them
high
in
five,
the name of
five.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
If it wasn't for the chair, I would have run to you and just, just slapped the screen and
praise
say,
be to Jesus.
And say, high five.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Prophet Denzel, out in Cape Town, we are coming to you. We are coming
Amen.
To you out
Amen.
In Cape Town. He says, powerful, a great man of God. We've got Anthea van der Bale as well. Thank you for joining there, Anthea. The Lord bless you, Isabel, Nelly. We love every single one of you. Unati, Fifi, Sali. The Lord bless you guys. Wow, I feel so good this morning. I believe deliverance took place.
Amen.
You know, Pastor Harry, this is what usually happens in the life of many believers. When you talk about strongholds, these are things that we struggle to break in our lives for the longest of times.
Yeah.
And this word here broke that today.
Amen.
This word broke that stronghold this morning in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Family, Amen. We love you. We love you so, so much. But before we go this morning, I want to remind you with regards to the pop-up studio, we are already next week. In next week, sometime, we will be out somewhere, but keep it locked on the Way Evangelistic Ministry. We will give you the details. We are coming through to your homes, wherever you are watching from, whether you're in Cape Town, you're in Bloemfontein, you are in Mpumalanga, we're going to be touring the whole of South Africa, but specifically those that are watching the stream here in the morning, we will be coming and live streaming in your house.
Amen.
We are making a commitment. We will be streaming
amazing.
In your house.
That
but here
amazing.
In this coming week, we will be around Pretoria, Johannesburg. But we're kicking it off this coming week. So you might never know. You must just expect a call from me or Pastor Pinky. We will tell you that we are coming to broadcast in your home.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. Praise
That's
the
amazing.
Lord. We love you. We bless you. Remember, Sunday morning, 9 a.m., we've got intercession. And of course, 10 a.m., we have our worship service. And if you are in the east of Pretoria, I want you to go to KCC, that is Kingdom Christian Church. That's where Pastor Harry is pastoring a great church in the east of Pretoria, Kingdom Christian Church.
That's right. Thank you so much, Pastor Tabo. Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Pinky, for the opportunity.
Yeah.
It's been great to come and share and serve you. Yes, we are Kingdom Christian Church. We are 272 Faro Road in Equestria in Pretoria.
Come on.
Our services, we have an Afrikaans service that starts at 8 o'clock.
Come on.
Daar praat ek Afrikaans.
Afrikaanse salve.
Daar is die Afrikaanse salve. Daar bedien ons die woord van die Here in Afrikaans. And then 9:15, we have an English service.
Amen.
So if you don't do Afrikaans, you can also come.
9:15.
Yeah, we've got a few services. So you come 9:15.
Yeah.
And join us there at 272 Faro Road, Equestria, here in Pretoria East. Kingdom Christian Church.
We Hallelujah.
Are also, amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise
amen.
The Lord. Praise the Lord. Before we go, please. I know Pastor Pinky is handling some things there in the you know behind the scenes. But before we go, today I wanna sing a happy birthday song to my brother, my biological brother, Khotso Mahasani. It's the 22nd of October. It's his birthday this morning, as well as a great man of God, Pastor Sherwin Haynes, out in Pietermaritzburg, a great man of God. We wanna sing a happy birthday. Birthday song to them here this morning, and yes, lekker feks van ochtend man. Jy is feks man.
Ek is gewoonlik die tyd dat as ek in die gym in.
Ja. So ons gaan bietjie dans nou, hoor.
Ja.
Ons gaan bietjie dans.
Ons gaan nou skud, hoor.
Dat sê.
Ja.
Let's do it.
Ja, we gaan sê ons skud ons 'n biskuit.
That's it, my bishop. Okay, so please, before we go, can we sing for my brother as well as Pastor Sherwin Haynes out in Marysburg? I hope you guys are ready. Come on, let's get it going. Pastor Harry, you know how we do it here. You know how we do the happy birthday dance. And I want
to... No, you can do it.
No. We're doing it together.
Happy birthday.
No. That's not the one. That's not the one. Yeah.
Happy birthday.
Come on. Yes.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
The bishop! You do it so well, man.
Yeah,
I think you've just beat me on that one.
Let's try.
I think you just beat me on that one.
Never give me title. You got the title.
Love you, bishop. Love you.
He's still the WBC champion. Yeah. I'm just a...
Love you, man. Family, thank you for joining us here this morning. You know who I am. I'm your favorite evangelist, together with the beautiful African queen, Pastor Pinky. She's serving us in the background here this morning. And once again, I want to thank my mentor, my leader, my brother in the kingdom, Pastor Harry. Love you, man.
Thank you so much.
Love you so much.
Too.
Amen.
So
praise
much.
The Lord. Have yourselves a wonderful Friday. And we're going to see each other tomorrow morning for the Saturday morning prayer. Come ready, strapped, with your bulletproof vest and your camouflage and your boots. We are going into war tomorrow morning. Spiritual warfare. Come ready. 6 a.m. Bless you.
Hayate God.
Hayate Ntate.
Modimo ya lefano lefatshe.
Praise the Lord. Just as you are so diverse, man. Praise the